marijuana and the bright future of the industry in Malaysia, I would now like to invite Mr. Michael Liu, CEO of Arowana Berhad, to begin this morning's program.
Puan Mani Tan Abdullah, Deputy Secretary General of Consumerism and Management, Ministry of Domestic Trade, Cooperatives and Consumerism. VIP guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning. On behalf of Arowana Venture Berhad, allow me to welcome you to the launch of Arowana Venture Breeding Management Scheme, the first legalized interest scheme for captive arowana breeding in Malaysia. Malaysia is fortunate to be only one of three countries in the world which is able to breed the rare and highly valued Asian arowana in captivity. The area around the Bukit Merah Lake in the Kerian district in Perak, the oldest man-made lake in Malaysia, comprising an area of 7,000 acres, provides a natural habitat for the arowana. Arowana breeding projects around the lake have grown from less than 300 breeding ponds in year 2008 to 3,808 breeding ponds in 2010. Exports of the arowana are expected to hit 250 million in 2011 out of total export of ornamental fish valued at 1 billion. Competition is stiff, with Singapore and Indonesia ahead of Malaysia in terms of export numbers of this expensive breed of ornamental fish. However, like the colours of the scales of the arowana, the industry in our country has a very bright future given the conducive environment in which we operate. The recent approval by the Companies Commission of Malaysia of the Arowana Venture Breeding Management Scheme, managed by Arowana Venture Berhad, is the first legal interest scheme in Malaysia in the field of arowana breeding. Such schemes will attract much needed interest and investment into the industry. These investments will help move the industry away from small-scale farming and assist in achieving economies of scale through an increased number of breeding ponds and investments into modern technology and research, and also development into improving current farming methods and selective breeding to improve the quality of breeding stock. And because this interest scheme is tightly regulated by the Companies Commission of Malaysia and overseen by my Premier Trustee Berhad, the interests of investors are protected. Investors who participate in the scheme will benefit from the sale of arowana fries produced under the scheme and enjoy a healthy return on their investment over a 10-year period. The highback arowana is a crossbreed between the Malaysian golden crossback arowana and the red-tailed golden arowana, and it is in big demand due to its beauty, scarcity and ease of looking after them. The road to today's launch has been a long and arduous one over the past 2 years, but it was well worth it. Today, the Arowana Venture Breeding Management Scheme is the only legalized and registered interest scheme in arowana breeding. This means that investors who invest through this scheme will be rest assured that their investment is guaranteed by the checks and balances put in place by legislation and government authorities. In launching the Arowana Venture Breeding Management Scheme, we are thankful to the various government agencies, namely the Companies Commission of Malaysia. They have been instrumental in enabling SMEs in the agriculture and aquaculture sector, such as Arowana Venture Berhad, raise capital for startup and expansion through alternative funding schemes, such as a share farming scheme or scheme Kongsi Tani under Division 5, Part 4 of the Companies Act 1965. The stringent but necessary measures implemented by the Companies Commission of Malaysia is a good approach to ensure that the investors' interests are protected. Among these measures is the approval of a trustee to safeguard the trust accounts, an approved independent consultant who oversees the technical aspects of the scheme, an approved trust deed which legally binds the parties, and a prospectus which explains the characteristics of the scheme to potential investors. We would also like to thank the Fisheries Department of Malaysia for assisting in terms of research and technical expertise. One example is the development of a DNA kit for the identification of the gender and strain of the arowana. I would also like to personally thank the Deputy Secretary General of Consumerism and Management under the Ministry of Domestic Trade, Cooperatives and Consumerism, Puan Mahanithan Abdullah, for taking time off her busy schedule to launch this event. Last but not least, a big thank you to everyone for being here to witness the launch of the Arowana Venture Breeding Management Scheme. Thank you.